Good morning. Today we talk about the thoracic cavity. The thoracic cavity is limited above by the bony boundary called as the thoracic inlet, and inferiorly it is limited by the diaphragm, which separates it from the abdominal cavity here. The thoracic cavity here is exposed by the removal of the ribs and the intercostal muscles, and anteriorly the manubrium sternum, the body of the sternum and the symphysternum. We have removed this to expose the thoracic cavity. The interior of the thoracic cavity can be divided basically into two parts: the central fibrous partition, which is called as the mediastinum, and the cavity occupied on either side by the lung. So here you can see this is the left lung occupying here. On the right side, we have removed the right lung to expose the pulmonary, the bronchi. So here what you see is the left lung. The left lung extends into the root of the neck, and this part of the lung, which forms the conical part, is the apex of the lung. The base of the lung lies opposed to the diaphragmatic surface, and it is intimately related to the mediastinum on both sides, the right and the left. So now we go on into identifying the parts of the lung. So here this is the apex, and here you have the base of the lung. This is the mediastinal surface, and this is the costal surface. Each lung is aerated by the bronchi. The bronchi are formed by the division of the trachea. The structure seen here in yellow is the trachea, which consists of cartilaginous rings anteriorly, and posteriorly you have the collapsed wall formed of the trachealis muscle. The trachea is the continuation of the larynx at the level of C6 vertebra. The trachea bifurcates at the level of the manubriosternal angle here, and it divides into the right bronchus and the left bronchus. So this which you see here is the right bronchus. The right bronchus has got an extrapulmonary part, which is shorter, wider and more vertical, and an intrapulmonary part where it divides into the lobar bronchi for each of the lobes. So you have the upper, the middle and the lower lobar bronchi colored respectively in red, blue and green. Each lobar bronchi again divides into segmental bronchi, which go on to aerate the bronchopulmonary segments. So these are called as the tertiary bronchi, which aerate the bronchopulmonary segments. Now on the left side also you have the similar structure, where the bronchus, the left bronchus, is longer and narrower and divides into an upper one and a lower one, because the left lung has got only two lobes. Now I go on into the mediastinum. The mediastinum, for descriptive purposes, is divided by an imaginary plane, which passes anteriorly through the articulation of the manubrium sternum and the body of the sternum. And it is at this level that you have the articulation of the second costal cartilage. Posteriorly, this plane passes through the lower border of the fourth thoracic vertebra. Now, at this level, it is divided into an upper part and a lower part. The upper part, which lies above this level, is called as the superior mediastinum, while the part below this is called as the inferior mediastinum. Now, if you look at it, you have an anterior region which is composed of very minimal tissue, fibroareolar tissue, the thymus and the sternothyroid and the sternohyoid muscles taking origin. Now we go on to the middle mediastinum, which is occupied massively by the heart. So this structure which you see here is the heart. The heart has got two sides basically: the left side, which we call as the arterial side, and the right side, which we call as the venous side. So this is the right auricle which you see here, and this is the right atrium. And now this is your right ventricle, and this is your left ventricle. This is the middle mediastinum, which is occupied mainly by the heart and by its covering, which is called as the pericardium. So here what you see here is the pericardium, and the pericardium is closely opposed to the central tendon of the diaphragm, because the outer layer of the pericardium, which is called as a fibrous pericardium, has got a common developmental origin with the central tendon of the diaphragm, which is the septum transversum. Now we go on to the middle mediastinum, which is the heart, the right auricle, which I have said, the right atrium. The right atrium receives the superior vena cava here, which is formed by fusion of the brachiocephalic veins. So this is the left brachiocephalic vein and this is the right brachiocephalic vein. They join together at the level of the first costal cartilage to continue as the superior vena cava. The superior vena cava receives the arch of the aesygous vein at the level of the second costal cartilage. Now, at this level, the superior vena cava becomes intrapericardial in nature. So, this is the extrapericardial part of the superior vena cava, while this is the intrapericardial part of the superior vena cava. The other structures which you can visualize in the superior mediastinum are the arch of aorta with its main branches. So here what you have is the brachiocephalic trunk. This is the left common carotid artery and this is the left subclavian artery. So these are the structures which you have here arising from the arch of the aorta. As I go posteriorly in the middle, in the superior mediastinum, I can identify the trachea and the esophagus. So we will be having a detailed class on the relations of the arch of aorta with a specimen in which the lung has been removed so as to expose the vagus and the recurrent laryngeal nerve. So these are the structures which you can clearly visualize in this specimen. Thank you for your hearing.